This is Dr. Richard Zafonja. I'm a hematologist and oncologist. The topic today is bone marrow aspiration and biopsy. Bone marrow aspiration and biopsy is a diagnostic procedure as opposed to bone marrow transplantation, which is a therapeutic procedure. First, an informed consent must be obtained from the patient or the patient's family or guardian. Local anesthesia is usually used in adults, generally using lidocaine. General anesthesia may be used in children. The location of the procedure is the iliac bone, specifically posterior superior iliac spine in most cases. In obese patients, the sternum is the preferred location. Indication for bone marrow aspiration and biopsy are blood disorders, for example, unexplained anemia, low platelets, high platelets, elevated red cells, elevated white cells, low white cell counts, leukemia, myelodysplasia, multiple myeloma. Solid tumors and possible infiltration into the bone marrow are also indications for bone marrow aspiration and biopsy. And these solid tumors include breast cancer, prostate cancer, and lymphomas. Infections, especially tuberculosis, may also be an indication for bone marrow aspiration and biopsy. Last but not the least is fever of undetermined origin. Average time spent for bone marrow aspiration and biopsy is 20 minutes. There are a few questions that a few patients might have. And these are, one, do I get cut during this procedure? The answer is no. Do you need stitches? The answer is no. Observation is usually performed for about 10 to 15 minutes while the patient lies on their back so that pressure can be applied on the site of operation to ensure that there is no bleeding before discharge. Please note that patients who are on aspirin or blood thinners like Coumadin bleed a lot more after the procedure, so it is advisable to discontinue these medications before bone marrow aspiration and biopsy is done. Tests that can be performed on bone marrow aspirate and cord biopsy are as follows: culture and sensitivity, bone marrow smear, flow cytometry for CD markers, histopathology, other molecular and genetic mutational studies, chromosome studies, and FISH, which is fluorescent in situ hybridization test. Thank you.